Hi, I wanted to share with you guys a few JavaScript APIs that you might not be too familiar with. I'm going to list them right here in this page. We're just going to chuck them in. Add content editable to this H1, paste them in. This works for now. Alright, the first one is classList. After that, we're going to talk about dataset, matchMedia, textContent, matchesSelector. We'll get right into it. ClassList is a better API for dealing with the class name of an element. Normally we do a lot of string manipulation, it's not so much fun. But ClassList gives us an API that we really deserve. So I'm going to go over here to this little panel over here. You can see that this li has a class of selected on it, and it gives us this light blue background. Now, I want to add that class to another one. So I'm going to bring up the console by hitting escape. And I'm going to be using a shortcut, $0, just refers to whatever element I have selected right here. So, $0 dot classList add selected. Now there it is. It just adds the class of selected. I could also add, let's say, okay. That works. Now, as you can imagine, a remove also works. So I can remove my selected class back. And of course, a toggle. So I can toggle that on and off. As you can see, the class is being toggled, as is the nice blue background. So that's about it. Next is element.dataset. I'm going to go over this page right here. This is a page of talks that my team has done lately. And each of the talks in the markup that we're using here, we're using a bunch of article elements. And on each of the article elements, we use an HTML5 data attribute. And it says data event, and it lists out the event name. I like that for CSS selectors and give a nice styling hook. So let's see. I'm going to reference this element again. And the old way of getting at this is get attribute. And I can get my attribute with data.event. That works. But we also now have dataset. So I can say dataset and go straight to event, and that returns back that string. I'm going to add in one more here. So we're going to add in data.place-name. Probably need to give it a value. I'll say Brazil. Now, one thing you should be aware of is that if you use an extra hyphen, it will be camel-cased over in dataset. So just be aware of that. But the cool thing about dataset is that you ask for just it, and you get back this DOM string map, which is essentially an object which just has all the data attributes. So it kind of collects them, rounds them up, and gives it back to you as an object. It's really nice. Alright, the next is window.matchMedia. Now, this is a kind of fun one. So I'm going to type window.matchMedia. So this basically is a JavaScript API for testing to see if a certain media query that we use in CSS, if that's going to pass. But now you can see in JavaScript. So I'm going to type out only screen, and max width is 700 pixels. I think that's about right. Returns back this media query list object, which is a little kind of funky. But the thing that we're most interested in is the matches attribute. So currently, this media query, if I had this in my style sheet, this would not be passing. Let me try resizing my window a little bit. No, we're not passing yet. Okay, so we've now reduced the window to less than 700 pixels, so that's going to pass. So anyways, there's matchMedia. Test out your media queries. Next is textContent. And textContent's been around for a little while, but I just want to cover it real quick. TextContent is an API for just seeing what is the text value of a DOM subtree. So I'm going to ask for the DOMs, text content of this footer down here. And here we get back just the text that, you know, your users are seeing. This is somewhat similar to the intertext attribute that is also on DOM elements. But there is a small difference where intertext is cognizant of the styles that you're applying, and let's say an element in here was display none, intertext would not return that in its result, whereas text content would. So there's a slight difference, but most of the time it doesn't matter too much. Text content is supported in IE9 and absolutely every other browser, so you're good to use it. The last one I want to show is matches selector. This is a really fun one. So I'm going to go down here, and these links, this little table of contents, I'm going to select one of these. So this link, the element, I'm going to call matchesSelector on it. Currently, this is prefixed, so it's WebKit matchesSelector. Over in Firefox, it's Moz matchesSelector. And so I'm going to ask, hey, does this element, would it match against a selector like A? And it would, because it's an A tag. Whereas it's not an LI, so this is false. It is an A inside an LI. And it's also OLTOCLIA should be true, because here we go. So that's pretty cool. Where this comes in really handy is over in event delegation. So I'm going to bring up a little bit of code right here. So what we have here is a little bit of event delegation code. We're going to bind a click handler to the document. And what we want to do here is, if I click on one of these links, I want to do a smooth scroll down the page, down to wherever its content is. But so here's the tricky part. You know, we need to figure out wherever we click, what is that element, and does that element match the thing that we're targeting? So we got to write this out, but we can kind of cheat a little bit. I'm just going to steal this code right here, this match selector. But we need an element here to base that off of. What we're going to do is we're just going to grab this event object that was passed into the listener, and I'm going to grab the target off of that, and that refers to whatever element initially received that click. And so event.target, we want to see if that matches a selector, which indicates that it is indeed one of these. And if it is, then we're going to do a smooth scroll or alert. Otherwise, do nothing. So I'm just going to try that out. Okay, that seemed to work. And I click other places, nothing's happening. I click on these guys, and yes! Okay, that's it. So anyways, 5 APIs. Hope you're a little bit more familiar with them now, and hope to see you using them. Thanks.